He prayed did we pray, our prayers would be accepted before the fathers through the prayer of Jesus. He fasted, so that when we fast, our fast will be accepted through the Father, before the Father, through Jesus Christ. He did charitable deeds, so that when we do charitable deeds, will be accepted before the Father in Jesus Christ. So, if we want to be accepted before the fathers, we need to abide in the Son, be united in Him, and He united in us. That's why you read today in the green letter from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, St. Paul said, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. So when you abide in Christ and you accept Him, you are a new creation. The old man, the corrupted man, is gone. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Now all things are of God, God the Father, who has reconciled us to Himself through Jesus Christ. So God the Father reconciled us to Himself, accepted us again to Himself through Jesus Christ, and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, that God was in Christ reconciling the world to Himself. So God the Father in Christ reconciled us to Himself, accepted us again, not imputing their trespasses to them, and has committed to us the word of reconciliation. So St. Paul said, we are ambassadors for Christ. As though God were pleading through us, we implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. So, in order actually to be accepted before God the Father, we need to be reconciled, we need to be one, we need to be united, we need to be abiding in the Lord Jesus Christ, and thus you will be accepted before God the Father. But what separates me from the Lord Jesus Christ? All of us, we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. All of us, we were baptized. But what separates me from the Lord Jesus Christ? Because if I am separated from the Lord Jesus Christ, then I am not accepted before God the Father. Definitely, if we disobey the commandment of God, if we drift away from His commandments. So, any time we drift away from the commandment of God, or we follow our own will, not the will of the Father, and we disobey God and His commandments, then we are separated from the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why we need to repent and return back, because through repentance we are reconciled again with the Lord Jesus Christ and will find acceptance. So in order to be acceptable before God the Father, we need to walk in all the commandments of God. And if we break any commandment, we need to repent immediately and instantly, so that we be reconciled in Christ, and in Christ we will have acceptance before God the Father. Tomorrow we will commemorate St. John the Baptist on the second day of Thoout. And it's written about his parents, Zachariah and Elizabeth, that they were walking in all the commandments of God without blame. Blameless. See, we're walking in all the commandments of God. So we need actually to keep the commandments of God in our hearts. And thus we can walk before Him blameless. a lot of the commandments of God. We can summarize the commandment of God in one word, which is love. Love the Lord your God and love your neighbor as yourself. That's why you heard today in the Catholic letter from the first epistle of St. John, he who loves his brother abides in light, and there is no cause to stumbling in him. But he who hates his brother is in darkness and walks in darkness, and does not know where he is going, because darkness has blinded his eyes. God is light. When we love one another and we love God, we'll be walking in light. But if you don't love one another, and if you don't love God, then we are walking in darkness, and there is no fellowship between light and darkness. When we walk in darkness, we separate ourselves from God, and thus we are not accepted before God the Father. Also, what makes us accepted before God is the charitable deeds, the works of mercy. When one of the lawyers asked the Lord Jesus Christ, what is the greatest commandment in the scripture? And the Lord told him, love the Lord your God, love your neighbor as yourself. So this lawyer asked the Lord Jesus Christ, who is my neighbor? And the Lord gave him the parable of the Good Samaritan. The Good Samaritan was able to see the needs of the others and to be moved with compassion and to extend his hand in a merciful deed on the other, although he was his enemy, because there was enmity between the Jews and the Samaritan. Then the Lord said to the lawyer, do this and you will live. Do this and you will live. So in order to be accepted before God the Father, we need to have merciful and charitable deeds, even with our enemies, whether it's America. And the definition of mercy is the ability to see the needs of others and to be moved to compassion in your heart and to extend your hand to help the other, even if they are your enemies. This is actually the mercies that God actually will, that will make us acceptable before God the Father. That's why in Hosea chapter 6, verse 6, the Lord told us, there what do I need? I need mercy, not a sacrifice. I need mercy, not a sacrifice. That's what God needs from us, to be merciful in order to be acceptable. The merciful acts and the charitable deeds is considered an acceptable sacrifice before the Lord. And the last point, we should not actually touch what is unclean. As we read in 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 14 to 18, don't touch unclean, so I will accept you. Meaning what? Meaning we should not participate in the works of darkness. We as children of God, we are separate from the rest of the world. We are called out from the rest of the world. By the way, the word ikekisiria, ikekisiria means called out. So God called us out of the world. He told us, you are not of the world. St. Paul said, do not be conformed to the children of the world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind. Unfortunately, under the pressure of the society around us, many of us will want to be conformed conform to the world, to look like the children of the world. And in this way, actually, we will not be accepted before God the Father. In order to be accepted before God the Father, we need to be separate. The word consecration or holy means to separate. When we say we will consecrate this church, means we separate this church from the rest of the world to be a dwelling place for God. That's the word holy or consecration means. In the same way, we were consecrated in baptism to be separate from the rest of the world. And thus, we will be children of God, holy. But if we are conformed and we look like the children of the world and imitate them, actually, we will not be the children of God the Father. That's why the church shows to us the, from the book of Acts, chapter 17, the story of the people in Athens. We read about the people in Athens, for all the Athenians and the foreigners who were there to spend their time in nothing else but either to tell or to hear some new thing. So the people there just spent their time in hearing new things. And if they liked it, they would do, regardless if it's right or wrong. If they don't like it, they would dismiss it. That's how they spent their time. And when St. Paul actually started to preach to them about God and about Jesus Christ and his resurrection, they did not like it. That's why when they heard of the resurrection of the dead, some mocked, while others said, we will heal you again in this matter. Well, we don't have time enough for you. Just go heal you again. And St. Paul departed from there. So the people in Athens, instead of keeping themselves separate from the world and listen to the word of God that can transform them and change them and help them to attain the eternal salvation, no, they spent their time in looking for what's new and just imitate the children. But we, the children of God, we should not do like this. So when we are starting the new Coptic year, the church is telling us, do you want to have this year acceptable year to the Lord? You need to abide to the Lord Jesus Christ, because he is the only one accepted before the Father. You need to walk in his commandments, especially the commandment of love, because the whole Bible can be summarized in love. Also, you need to be merciful and to do charitable deeds. God will accept the merciful because he will have mercy on them. Blessed are the merciful because they shall contain mercy. And you need to be separate from the world. You need to be separate. You are not of the world. You are heavenly citizens. Once you are baptized, we acquire the citizenship of heaven. So now we are just ambassadors. We are visitors. We are strangers here. We are sojourners here. We don't have a unique city here on earth. We know our heaven, our home, our citizenship is in heaven. So our sojourners here, we are on a journey going back to our eternal home. So we are praying with him, David, saying in the book of Psalms, you will bless the crown of the year because of your goodness, and your plains shall be filled with fairness. Rejoice in God our helper. Shout aloud the God of Jacob. Rejoice in him because he made through the new covenant that our time is the acceptable year of the Lord, in which after we will rejected and were exempt from the rights of joy, now we are reconciled and now we are restored back to our eternal home, and glory be to God forever and ever.